right. Okay, tell me your name.
My name is Ahmad Dzuizz and Najib.
Mm-hmm. How old are you?
I am 11 years old.
Yeah. Okay. So tell me, what is coding for you?
It's a mind sport.
It's a mind sport. What do you mean by mind sport?
It's to specifically competitive programming. It's to exercise my mind.
Okay, so but that's competitive programming, but coding is not just competitive programming, right? So what is coding? Is it always mind sport even though it's not competitive programming?
No, not really.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's like when you have to make a game or something. Mm-hmm. You want to make a platform or something, right? A game.
Mm-hmm.
Then you need to be creative and then know what your design is.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. So, what do you do now? And you are 11 years old, right?
Yeah.
So, what do you do now in terms of coding these days?
Competitive programming.
Okay. And you're using
C++.
C++ now, yeah.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So that's your main focus on coding now. So, but tell me more about how did you get into coding? How did you start learning? Like from how many years old and how did you start it? How did you pick up until now you're doing competitive programming in C++? Tell me the journey.
First, I start with with logical thinking, like with Scratch and WebRush. No, not Scratch. With WebRush and Dr. City and the exercises and stuff like that, right? And brain games, book, yeah, and puzzles.
Mm-hmm.
Then I learned the building blocks. Like where I, how I structure the, how I order the functions. And
okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And using then? Scratch and others.
Mm-hmm.
And then I learned what to write.
What to write. Okay. Mm-hmm. From Scratch and then what to write. Okay. How?
Hmm? Oh, using Python. At first using Python.
Okay.
First
using Python. Alright. Okay, tell me more about the logical thinking you said, right? So what do you mean? What are the examples of the logical thinking?
Specifically for computer programming?
When you start learning, when you were, before you actually type in Python.
Oh, it's, what I mean is like,
Pick some simple examples that you remember.
I don't remember.
You don't remember already? How many years ago already? Yeah. Okay. So when you start Python, do you still remember how you started Python?
No.
But you forgot already. Okay.
I forgot.
But why did you like Python? I mean, why did starting with Python eventually hook you up with coding? Right? I mean, make you kind of like doing coding?
The number one reason that I didn't tell you just now.
Mm-hmm.
Is turtles.
Turtles, yeah. Python turtles. Yeah. Why is it fun?
Because you can draw.
You can draw.
And then using math, you can learn.
You mean geometry?
Yeah, geometry.
Okay, the coordinates, x, yeah. Y coordinates.
And also how to draw a hexagon using loop.
Using loop, like drawing using hexagon and many gons, lah. Yeah. Not just hexagon, right? Hexagon, pentagon, icosagon. Icosahedron, right?
Icosahedron.
It's also icosahedron. No, that's three. Okay. Right. So after Python, what did you do with Python after you pick up how to code in Python? Do you remember what did you do with Python?
After I learned how to write in Python. And like I mastered enough, I like become average, mm-hmm. I become good enough. I got distracted with HTML and C++. CSS.
HTML and CSS. Distracted. Yeah. Why do you say distracted? Why was it a distraction?
Because it's like I changed my objective for a while, and then after that I came back.
Okay, so you learn how to build simple website, and it was a distraction. Yeah. Then you came back to Python.
Yeah.
Okay. Then what did you do in Python? I mean, the last time you do Python. Now you are doing C++, right? You say.
Yeah. The last time I did Python was also competitive programming until I realized how slow it is, and then changed to C++.
How slow it is? Okay. Like slow for competitive programming, like, give me an example, like what kind of problem that you couldn't solve using Python?
Like the ones in CATIS. Yeah.
The ones in CATIS?
Okay. A lot where time limit exceeded.
Time limit exceeded, okay. But then when you do it in C++, then your code passed, accepted.
Yes.
Okay. So now that you are already starting doing C++, how do you compare as a child, right? You're still a child, 11 years old, between Python and C++. What do you think from a child's point of view?
What do you mean from a child's point of view?
How do you compare? As a child, what do you think between Python and C++?
For C++, the functions, the built-in functions, some of them require some explaining. Like upper bound is not, it's not the below, of, it's not the exact up, right? And yeah, and lower bound also. But then Python is self-explanatory. The functions have the what they do, the built-in functions.
Okay. Okay, so what do you like about coding, and what do you not like about coding?
That depends on my mood.
Depends on your mood. Okay.
Depends on.
Yeah, but what do you like from it? Like sometimes you like it, sometimes you don't.
Yeah.
Depend on thing of your mood. But when you do like it, what is actually there in coding that makes you like it?
You mean for what I like about coding as in competitive programming is like I learned something new and I finally solved this one task, one question of the code forces problem list like that. But when the like not competitive, the one where you just make your own game using Pygame or Turtle like that, right? It just feels nice for it just feels amazing when you what call it when you use when you like make a game and then you play it then just you feel so satisfied like this is so good.
There's a sense of satisfaction after you achieve something or you complete something or you build something using coding. So what do you not like? What do you not like from coding?
When I'm tired, I don't like thinking.
let's say you're not okay, so only when you're tired. So if you're not tired, you like coding. All right, now last question. So what do you want to see yourself in the future, or where do you want to go from now in terms of coding or the world of information technology, so to speak? Computer technology or computer, I don't know what to call it. In terms of coding,
I hope to like improve my coding skills, and then make it a hobby to participate in contests, something like that. Like what I do with Math Olympiad, then the same fun. And
all right.
That, yeah.
Okay. Good. Thank you so much. Have a good night. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.